Roberto, once more, stand for me. With our Lord, say, si, si. Si,
si.
Good. We don't want to put aside. Have my show. Are you okay?
Are you okay?
Show to that. Okay, hand down for me, please. Is that a two fingers?
No, interlock them.
Okay, third one, let's go.
One, two, three,
four. No, too fast.
So fast, hold it, please, let me see her. Slow down. So relax, let's go.
One, two,
three,
four.
Five, six, seven, eight.
4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. Very good. That's what C-Bars and Nutshell. The compression numbers. Thank you very much. And the last part I will show you guys is obviously an AD machine. It's a machine that sucks the art.
Mm-hmm.
It's simple, turn it on and tell you what to do.
Remove all clothing from patient's chest. The red handle to open back.
So, machine tell you what to do. You're counting two packs, you're color coded. Hope you can see, where do you put the yellow one? Where will you put the yellow pad?
On the just below
the
chest.
The right collarbone.
Collarbone.
And where will you put the red one?
Under the armpit.
Below the right, left armpit. These machines are available at High Foundation for sale, so you can call us if you want a machine to buy it. Every public space, every school, if you're a doctor, your private practice should have an AED machine. They are good, effective, and they're easy to use. Many hotels, many business spaces buy AED machines. When somebody collapses, they use a defibrillator. Because CPR load might not bring the person back to life. So a CPR, after training at High Foundation, it's good to know what to do if somebody is not responding, not breathing, have no sign of life. Any questions? That's it. Yes, sir.
Do you use a machine instead of pumping the chest?
Well, that's a good question. This is a scenario. If you're a low-level person, you use a machine first. Apply the pads, it will tell you what to do and you're counting a CPR. Alright? Now, if you are, say you are downstairs, machine's upstairs, send somebody to get the machine and start CPR first. So they work together, both the machine and compressions. Alright? So based on the scenario, it's if you're alone, machine is here, apply the pads, machine will build a shock, and say to you, continue CPR. Or if you're downstairs, machine is upstairs, you start CPR, and call you go upstairs for the machine, and continue the procedure.
What's the cost of the machine?
The machine costs about 2,000 euros. Very cheap, right? What's the cost of very somebody? All right, very good. Question in the back, sir. Yes.
That's my question.
Yes.
So, how would you do that?
Excellent question. Now, for a child, in this class, a child is at 1 to 8. So, you compress about 2 inches deep for a child. However, for the babies, though, it's much different. It's about 4 centimeters or 1.5 inches deep. So, adult and child are the same, 5 centimeters or 2 inches deep. But for infants, it's 4 centimeters or 1.5 inches deep. So, the depth of compression. Yes. So once you apply the pads, you go remove the pads. It'll say that you continue here. After 2 minutes, it'll realize and deliver a second shot. So it's pre-programmed. I thought you mentioned earlier, anybody can use the machine. The smaller the voice box tell you what to do, what not to do. The pads are not sticking correctly, say to you, check pads of good contact. So they're so good that anyone can use the machine, regardless of your training or your level of, or your profession. It's for everybody.
Question. In relation to the child, is it the same 30 chest compressions?
Yes. For all victims, once you're alone, it's the same 30 compressions to two breaths for adult, child, and infant victims. It's the same across the board. So, it's good to know what to do in case of emergency, and these machines that have CPR can save somebody's life. Any more questions? Thank you so much. Oh, one more? Yes. Very good question. And Dr. Trump mentioned earlier that you do CPR on your way to the hospital. So it's transport. So if you're alone in Stonyhill, right, I would encourage you to do CPR on your way to the nearest hospital. But I'm doing it on culture. Tell the person, throw in the vehicle, and drive fast to the nearest hospital. True? I will pray loud, God in bed now. Pray and cry and twist and turn. Little dog will put on the way, break the stoplights. True? And CPR is not being done. So we're promoting start CPR and continue CPR on the way to the hospital. That's what we're promoting. Don't just bother. Prayer is good, I believe in prayer, but CPR can work just as well. Amen? My last question for what time is about it? You will know, you'll see the sign. So the person's breathing, you'll see the person moving and you stop. Can you see that someone is unresponsive, has no breathing, has no sign of the life? So once they're moving or breathing, you won't have to see that victim. Alright, so the person's alive, you monitor them and transport them to the hospital. Transport is very vital. Yes, to the nearest hospital. Transport, you know, transport is important. So that's what we need to do our thing at the hospital, those doctors here. Good, thank you so much, it was a pleasure.